Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Pramodya Priyamathi from Faculty of Medical Sciences, University of Sri Jayawardenepura. First of all, I would like to thank the organizing committee of this international research, international conference for giving us the opportunity to present our research, which was conducted at undergraduate level at University of Sri Jayawardenepura. Our topic is hepatitis B virus transmission emphasized enough in the study curriculum of nursing and public health midwife students in Sri Lanka? Let's see what our research revealed. Healthcare workers are exposed to various bloodborne viruses during their practice, and hepatitis B virus and HIV being two important bloodborne viruses. There is a 30% risk of transmitting hepatitis B virus from a patient to a healthcare worker, and when it comes to HIV, it's 0.3%. Today, I'm presenting a part of a bigger research which was conducted to study the knowledge on transmission, prevention, and post-exposure prophylaxis of both HIV and hepatitis B virus. The objective of today's presentation is to describe the knowledge on known risk factors of transmission of hepatitis B virus among nursing and public health midwife students in a selected training school and their associated factors. Methodology. We carried out a descriptive cross-sectional study among 209 nursing students and 86 public health midwife students who have studied more than 6 months at the selected nursing training school. Data was collected using a pre-tested self-administered questionnaire and analyzed using SPSS software methodically. Those who had marks above the mean value were classified as having good knowledge, and those who had marks below the mean were classified as having poor knowledge. Ethical clearance was obtained from Ethics Review Committee, Faculty of Medical Sciences, University of Sri Jayawardenepura. Let's move on to the results. In figure one, the overall knowledge on transmission, prevention, and post-exposure prophylaxis is shown. As you can see, the level of good knowledge on transmission was comparatively poor when compared with the other two, and it was only 38%. Therefore, we decided to further analyze on the risk factors of transmission of hepatitis B, and the results are shown in figure two. As you can see from the blue color bars, majority of the study population has given correct answers for the transmission of hepatitis B virus through risk factors such as needle prick injuries and blood transfusion. Nevertheless, for needle stick injuries also, only 71% has identified it as a risk factor. Towards the end of the chart, you can see that majority has incorrectly stated that mosquito bites, swimming in pools, and other risk factors as transmission methods of hepatitis B virus. Further, it was studied that the students who received a formal education on the topics had a good level of knowledge on the topic of concern, and this was statistically significant. So in conclusion, the level of knowledge on transmission of hepatitis B virus was not satisfactory, given that the study population consisted of nursing and public health midwife students who are going to step into the field of healthcare in near future. So we recommend that more emphasis is given on the topic of transmission of bloodborne viruses, especially hepatitis B virus, so that the future healthcare workers would be competent enough to protect themselves from the bloodborne viruses and also to provide quality care for the community. Thank you very much for your patient listening.